Unit 2, Humor. Reading A, The Never Never Nest. The characters, Jack, Jill, his wife, Aunt Jane, nurse. The lounge of Jack and Jill's villa at New Hampstead. The essential furniture consists of a table on which are writing materials and two chairs. As the curtain rises, the lounge is empty, but Jack and Jill come in immediately, followed by Aunt Jane. And this is the lounge. Charming, charming, such a cozy little room and such pretty furniture. We like it, you know. Handy place to sit in and listen to the radiogram. Oh, have you got a radiogram as well as a car and a piano? Why? Of course, Aunt Jane. You simply must have a radio set nowadays. And it's so nice for me when Jack's away at business. I even make him move it into the kitchen so that I can listen to it while I cook. Sit down, Aunt Jane. You must be tired, and we have shown you everything now. What do you think of our little nest, Aunt Jane? I think it's wonderful, my dears. The furniture and the car and the piano and the refrigerator and the radio. What's it? It's wonderful, really wonderful. And we owe it all to you. Yes, Jack, that's what's worrying me. Worrying you, Aunt Jane? Yes, that check I gave you for your wedding present. It was only £200, wasn't it? I did not put 2,000 by mistake. Why no, Aunt Jane? What on earth made you think that? Well, that's all right. But I still don't altogether understand. This house, it's very lovely, but doesn't it cost a great deal for rent? Rent? Oh no, we don't pay rent. But Jack, if you don't pay rent, you'll get turned out into the street, and that would never do. You have Jill and the baby to think of now, you know. No, no, Aunt Jane, you misunderstood me. We don't pay rent because the house is ours. Yours? Why? Yes, you just paid £10 and it's yours. You see, Aunt Jane, we realized how uneconomic it is to go on paying rent year after year when you can buy and enjoy a home of your own for £10. And a few quarterly payments, of course. Why be Mr. Tenant when you can be Mr. Owner? I see. Yes, there's something in that. Even so, you must be getting on very well to keep up a place like this. Oh, he is, Aunt Jane. Why, only last year he had 5 shilling rise, didn't you, Jack? Of course, that was nothing really. I'm expecting 10 this Christmas. Jack, I've just thought of something. That car, is it yours? Of course it's ours. All yours? Well, no, not exactly all. How much of it? Oh, I should say the steering wheel and one of the tires. And about 2 of the cylinders. But don't you see? That's the wonderful thing about it. I don't see anything wonderful about it. But there is, Aunt Jane. You see, although we could never buy a car outright, we can enjoy all the pleasures of motoring for a mere £5 down. And the rest by easy installments, I suppose. Exactly. Exactly. And what about the radio? What's it? Well, that's the And the piano? Well, of course. And the furniture? I'm afraid so. I suppose all you own is this leg. She points to one. Well, no, as a matter of fact, it's that one. She points to another. And the rest belongs to Mr. Sage, I suppose. Yes. Well, I am not going to sit on Mr. Sage's part for anyone. Now, tell me, how much do all these installments come to? Well, actually to £7.08 a week. Good heavens, and how much do you earn? As a matter of fact, that is £6. But that's absurd. How can you pay £7.08 out of £6? Oh, that's easy. You see, all you have to do is to borrow the rest of the money for the payments from the Thrift and Providence Trust Corporation. They are only too glad to loan you any amount you like, on note of hand alone. And how do you propose to pay that back? Oh, that's easy too. You just pay it back in installments. Installments? Aunt Jane, is anything the matter? Would you like to lie down? Lie down? Do you suppose I'm going to trust myself in a bed that belongs to Mr. Sage or Marks and Spencer or somebody? No, I am going home. Oh, must you really go? I think I would better. I'll drive you to the station. What? Travel in a car that has only one tire and two thingamis? No, thank you. I'll take the bus. Well, of course you feel like that about it. Now, I'm sorry if I sounded rude, but really I'm shocked to find the way you're living. I've never owned a penny in my life. Cash down. That's my motto, and I want you to do the same. Now look, here's a little check I was meaning to give you anyway. Suppose you take it and pay off just one of your bills so that you can say one thing at least really belongs to you. Thank you, Aunt Jane. It's very nice of you. There, now I must be going. I'll see you to the bus anyway. Goodbye, Aunt Jane, and thanks so much for the present. Goodbye, my dear. Oh, nurse, I want you to run and post this for me. I look after the baby while you are gone. Certainly, madam. Well, she's gone. What a tartar. Still, she did leave us a bit on account. How much was it? £10. Phew! That's great! We can pay off the next 2 months on the car with that. I'm afraid we can't. Why ever not? You see, I have already sent it off for something else. Nurse has just gone to post it. Well, that's all right. Who have you sent it to? Dr. Martin. Dr. Martin? What on earth possessed you to do that? There, now you're going to be angry with me. I am not angry, but why waste good money on the doctor? Doctors don't expect to get paid anyway. But you don't understand. Understand what? Why, just one more installment and baby is really ours.